right, guys, welcome back to Downtown Rams. As always, I'm your host, Alexis Kraft, joined here with my co-host, Jake Ellenbogen. And we are continuing with our 2022 NFL draft prospect interviews. And joining us on the show right now, we have Mike Palmer, safety from Boston College. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you guys?
We're good. And just to start off, the interview here, just want to ask you what age you started playing football and when it became apparent that you could play in the NFL one day.
So I started playing football when I was actually 5 years old. I started playing flag football, and then where I'm from, you can actually, well, it used to be, I'm not sure if it's the same anymore, but you used to be able to start playing tackle football when you were six. So I got into it pretty young, and I wouldn't have wanted to do it any other way. I'm glad that I got into it that young, and it really shaped who I've become. And you learn so many lessons playing the game, even from a young age. So I'm really thankful for that. And I think to get to college first, it really came apparent to me my junior year of high school. There were some big games that we had where I played pretty well, and we won. We did well as a team, and it kind of really clicked with me that, you know, maybe I can go to the next level, be in the college level and have success and stuff. And for the NFL, it really wasn't until probably my third year, so my redshirt sophomore year of college, where things kind of started to click. And then I kind of started seeing some like real success, and all the hard work that I had put in the first 2 years of being there had finally really started to show and starting to pay off. And it felt really good, and I was really happy, and we were doing well as a team. And then it kind of hit me that, like, you know, maybe I can even go a little bit further. But no, so we'll see. Hopefully, fingers crossed.
For sure. And, you know, growing up, did you watch a lot of the NFL? And if so, who was your favorite player?
Growing up, we watched every Sunday. It was, you know, we loved watching football growing up. And my favorite player growing up was actually Adrian Peterson. Loved watching him, just the way he played the game. He always gave it his all. Every time he was on the field, it didn't matter what the score was, who they were playing. He always gave everything he had. And I really admired that about him.
Now, I want to know what made a New Yorker go to Boston College?
I was under-recruited, really, honestly, coming out of high school there. I didn't really have a lot of interest. It was like Wagner, Army, and Boston College, and that was about it. And out of those three schools, I went to Boston College, and I fell in love with the campus. I loved the coaching staff. The school, obviously, is great. Like, the education is incredible. You can't, like, compare that to anywhere. So that was a big thing. That was a big thing for my parents, definitely. They were like kind of pushing me there because of the education. So that definitely helped.
For sure. Yeah. You know, I've never been to Boston College, but we've interviewed several draft prospects from mm-hmm. Boston College, including this year. We interviewed your teammate, Isaiah Graham Mobley, from Boston College, and we've heard nothing but good things about it. And it seems like a really good school that produces a lot of good football players too, which is definitely a bonus. So if you were pitching to an incoming recruit who is interested at playing football and going to school, obviously at Boston College, how would you pitch the school and the football program to them?
The school, you don't really have to say much about the school. As soon as you step on campus, the school speaks for itself. It's amazing. Like, it's incredible. It's a beautiful scene. They're starting to really like renovate it and really like upgrade it. So they're definitely like, the school is putting in a lot of time. They're upgrading facilities all over the place. And like the coaching staff, the culture that they're developing is incredible. It's a great culture. It's like an open door culture. So the coaches' doors are open all the time. Like, you can walk up there whenever you want and stop in, and they'll have a conversation with you. They'll talk to you. They have you around their families a ton, which is awesome because it's great to build that relationship with like the family as well. You know, you're away from home. They basically are your family while you're up there. So to have that close relationship with them is huge. And they're great about that. They're real with you, which is all you can ask for. You can't ask for much more than that. You know, sometimes you're not going to like what you hear, but they're telling you because that's where you are, and that's the best interest. And I mean, sometimes that's hard, especially as an 18-year-old, 19-year-old to hear, but it really goes a long way in the long run. It's just, you know, the guys on the team are awesome too. It's a very welcoming environment. As soon as you step on campus, even as your recruiting visits, if you tell us like you're committed here or like you want to come here, we welcome you. Like they did it with me. You know, we did it with the guys coming in after me. It's just a great environment and it's a great culture, and it's only getting better and it's only getting closer.
Well, yeah. And it always seemed like, you know, you guys were really close, even with, you know, former players. I remember we were talking to Will Harris, and he mentioned he had like a group chat with John Johnson and Simmons, you know, like, Hamp Cheevers, and I forget the other one, but you guys have had a little bit of a factory there in the secondary from Boston College. So, you know, love to see that. But, you know, obviously with that being said, it leads to my next question here. You've gone up against a ton of competition. I mean, Boston College, you face a ton of really talented programs. Is there one guy in particular that stands out to you as the toughest player you faced?
There's a couple guys that come to mind. The first one, my redshirt freshman year, seeing Lamar Jackson in person he's a good player.
Just a little bit, right?
Yeah, he's a great player. And then a little bit later in my career, playing against Trevor Lawrence, he's a really talented guy, and same with Travis Etienne. Those are like three guys to me who really stand out, kind of amongst the guys that I was able to like see while I was up at BC.
Well, yeah, they're all very talented, for sure. I can imagine that they would be tough to play against. But, you know, in terms of games, is there any favorite game that you played in during your college career?
Ooh, that's a good question. The first game that comes to mind, I have to go back to 2018, probably. The Red Bandana game, which is a great game that Boston College does every year to represent Wells Crowther. That's an incredible story in itself. We were playing Miami. It's the first time we played Miami in a while. We had them up at our place. It was a colder night, and that was after the year where they had lost to Pitt in the final game of the regular season. So they were, you know, trying to rebound from that, and they were having a pretty good year to that point. And to be able to take them down was big for the program. It was a great win for us. It was an incredible night.
Well, that's certainly awesome. It sounds like it meant a lot, and definitely, I mean, you remembered it right off the bat. Love asking people, you know, what their favorite game was, because I mean, I don't think we've ever had someone that said, yeah, I didn't really have a favorite game. Like, you always kind of have an idea. My next question here is for you, you know, playing the defensive back role, whether you were going to play a corner or safety or whatever. I just want to get your thoughts on what you believe personally is the most important trait for manning any of those positions.
Mm-hmm. For me as a safety, I think one of the biggest things, definitely communication, being able to communicate throughout the, you know, the defensive backfield and the secondary to, you know, make sure the corners are on the same page, make sure, you know, the safeties are on the same page, the nickels. There's times where you even have to communicate with the linebackers, and sometimes in certain situations, you're even talking to some of the D linemen, telling them like what they have to do and if we have a change in a coverage or something like that. So just being able to communicate is huge. And I'd say being able to recognize formations quickly to be able to help get guys lined up and get the formations lined up is also another important component of being able to play that position at a high level.
And what would you say is your biggest strength as a player?
I'm definitely a good communicator on the field. Sometimes, you know, the day after I don't talk very well because my voice is gone from the day before. You know, we played in some pretty loud environments. So, you know, you have to scream, and sometimes even you got to use hand signals, but guys aren't always looking. So you have to make sure, you know, you have to start yelling. That's communicating is definitely probably my best feature.
And what is one area of your game you're looking to improve upon the most going in the NFL?
Just trying to refine technique and footwork. That's something that, you know, even the best are always trying to get better at, because there's always, you know, guys are always getting a step quicker, a step faster. So you have to, you know, make sure your footwork is on point and all that, your pad level, playing with good pad level. So just kind of trying to refine the techniques and the fundamentals of the game and really kind of taking a step back and slowing everything down to make sure I'm doing that at a really high level.
Yeah. And, you know, this next question is just kind of a fun question, but who are you most looking forward to facing in the NFL, like a receiver, tight end, running back, whoever, who are you most looking forward to going up against?
That's a good question. You know, I know it's a popular answer with you guys, but you got to go with Tom Brady. You have to. You know, who wouldn't want to play against him? And that little mental, like the mental battle that goes on with him, reading coverages and everything, and, you know, trying to disguise stuff to play back at him. I mean, that would be, you can't ask for anything more fun than that.
Yeah, I got to say, we've never gotten that answer before. I'm absolutely kidding. I think we just got the answer the last like however many interviews that we've done, but no, I mean, it makes sense, you know, of course. Yeah. And I think the only time we didn't get that answer is when he was retired for like a week. So, yeah, no, I definitely hear you there. Now I want to, you know, pivot over because we are a Rams centric podcast. So I have to ask you, have you spoken to the Los Angeles Rams throughout this draft process?
I personally have not had spoken with the Rams yet. You know, hopefully things would pick up. That'd be awesome. It'd be great. But as of right now, I haven't spoken with the Rams.
Well, we always tell prospects that the Rams are known to draft guys that they never contact at all. They are one of those teams. So I always tell people, even if you haven't heard from the Rams, it does not mean that they're not interested in and not keeping an eye on you. And who knows, maybe they'll even draft you. Maybe they won't, but they still might, because they've definitely done it in the past from guys that we've talked to. But, you know, just to close this out here in your own words, who is Mike Palmer as a person and who is he as a player?
As a person, a very genuine person that someone can, you know, that you can come to and look for help. But anyway, I like helping people. I want to help any way possible. Just like a very genuine person. Sometimes soft spoken in certain aspects, sometimes a little more spoken, but just very genuine. And then on the field, very, very competitive. I don't say much, like, especially when it comes like to the other team. I really don't say anything, you know. I try not to let my, I don't want my opponents to see what my emotions are. I don't want them to see me when I'm too high. I don't want them to see me when I'm down. I try to keep that in check. But just like a fiery competitor. I love to compete. I just love playing the game. It's so much fun. I enjoy it a lot.
I hear you. And I mean, that makes a lot of sense. You don't want to give anything that your opponent can use against you. You don't want to give them any sort of intel on that. I'm going to ask you a final question here off the gridiron. But before I do, I'm very curious. So are you like, do you talk with John Johnson at all? Because I know he obviously went to the program.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Every now and then. Yeah, I do. So my freshman year was John's senior year.
Yeah.
So I was actually very fortunate enough to be able to, you know, learn from him from a year. And he's an incredible football mind. He the way he sees the game is so smart, and it's incredible. I mean, he's helped me tremendously.
Well, I'm not surprised by that. We fell in love with him, you know, with him being with the Rams. But I was just curious because I'm going to embarrass Alexis here. She went on his Instagram live, I want to say a year ago or whatever. I think it was right around Valentine's Day. I think that was like
That's why.
So I was wondering if you noticed her, like remembered her at all, if you happened to just be in the Instagram live or caught any of it.
I didn't happen to be in the Instagram live. So I didn't. So.
It was just me and John complaining about Valentine's Day. Yeah, we were just making a lot of points as to why Valentine's Day is overrated, and we were just hanging out. I talked to John very, very occasionally. I'll check in with him and see how he's doing. But yeah, great guy for sure. Definitely got close on an Instagram live, really bonded us. But yeah, that was a fun time. But yeah, Boston College, their defense, I think I tweeted like, maybe it was 2 years ago. Maybe it was a year ago. What did I tweet, Jake? You might remember. I said something how Boston College is becoming the new like DBU.
Right? Well, I mean, they really were. I mean, I think you guys are. I mean, I gotta say, when I interviewed Will Harris at the Senior Bowl, I mean, it's I don't know what it is with you guys. You guys are humble, but you're freaks on the field. You know, you tear it up, but I don't know. It's just the coaching, but also I think just kind of, you know, they go after the right guys as well. Like they recruited you and other teams clearly made a mistake, you know, not going after you, and you did them a favor, but also I think you've put yourself in a position where you could very easily be playing in the NFL. So, you know, I think that's just a common theme with, you know, defensive backs that are coming from Boston College, whether it's a safety or a corner. You know, it's just, I mean, obviously we know what Simmons can do over in Denver. So, I mean, it's, you know, it's not like it's, you know, one guy. I mean, it's always fun to look at those trends though, because you'll see it. I mean, like Washington, they always have a bunch of DBs and LSU, but I don't think Boston College gets enough credit for what they've done and what you guys have done in particular.
Yeah. The coaching staff does an unbelievable job of they do an incredible job recruiting. They go out and they find guys who might be overlooked or, things of that nature. And then when they get us all together, we just gel so well together. And that's such a huge part of playing well in the secondary, is having that connection with the guys and just gelling well and, you know, having trust in each other and, you know, playing like brothers and stuff like that. So it's like I said earlier, you know, it's family. So when you're playing next to family, you're going to play a lot harder for each other. And I think that's one thing BC does a great job of, is instilling that family in each other. And it helps us a lot, definitely. But, you know, having those guys, it's awesome to be able to come in as a young guy and learn from the older guys who are great players and try to keep that going.
Yeah. And you guys will be close forever, for sure. You know, teammate bond. But before we get out of here, we do have three questions that are non-football related.
Okay.
Because we love recommendations. So if you could please recommend us a TV show, an album, and then a snack. And that snack question is for me because I'm obsessed with snacks. And I like to have a snack when I watch a TV show. So I want a recommendation for both.
Okay. I like it. So I'll start with the music first. I'm not a huge music guy. But you know, one album I really, really like is I think it's called Evolve by Imagine Dragons. Came out quite a few years ago, but it's a good album. It's got, you know, a song that comes to mind is Thunder. It's on it. It's a good song.
Oh, yeah. I like that.
And then recently TV shows, I don't know if you guys have seen it yet, but Anatomy of a Scandal. It's on Netflix.
Is that like a docuseries?
It's a short series. So it's
like a limited series.
Okay. It's only six episodes. They haven't said they were going to have a second season to it, but that was a really good show. It's one of the better shows I've seen in a while.
Is it fiction or is it like documentary style, like docuseries?
So I did a little bit of research about it. It's kind of both. It's not based off of a singular true story, but it's based off of, I think it's like a British press person who would like be in courtrooms and kind of just observed things that were going on.
Okay.
So it's like a compilation of a whole bunch of different things, but it's good. Definitely watch it.
Those short series on Netflix, I mean, they're very interesting. Alexis and I saw, what was it? The woman across the street through the window or whatever, the one with, was it Kristen Bell? And it was like, what are we watching? Like it was mind boggling. I can't say I would 100% recommend that of everything, but it was definitely, it was something.
Yeah.
It was entertaining. I will give it entertaining. That, but I don't know how much rewatchability it has.
Yeah. Like this Anatomy of a Scandal, you could watch it like probably like three or four times and pick up something new every time you watch it. I think they'll end up doing a second season of it because it's so popular, but if they don't do a second season, I mean, the first season definitely is killer.
Yeah.
And then for snacks, again, simple. I love Goldfish.
Oh,
Can't go wrong. Goldfish.
That's my favorite. Just the classic cheddar. When I go like to work, I will bring bags of Goldfish. So... yeah, I love Goldfish. Definitely a good snack. But yes, all good recommendations. I'll have to check out that show. And yeah, the snack, like I said, 100% agree. my favorite. But anyways, thank you so much for coming on the show. We really, really appreciate it. We know it's a very busy time. We're 8 days away now from the draft, which is crazy. Like this month flew by, at least for us. For people going into the draft, it probably feels like it's taking forever. But for us, it flew by because we've been interviewing all these draft prospects like every day. And it just seems like we're getting closer and closer and closer to the draft. So it's very exciting. So stay healthy. You know, we wish you the best of luck. We would very much like to see you on the Rams, but we will be fans no matter what team you go to and be following your success.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you guys having me on. Thank you for taking the time and giving me the opportunity. It means a lot.
Absolutely. You take care. We'll stay in touch and stay healthy.
Definitely. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.